Hello, welcome again back to Global Associates video lecture series on accounting and other subjects. I'd like to continue with the SBR, Strategic Business Reporting, on ethical duties of accountant. And on my previous video, I discussed one specific requirement about ethical issues, an example for ethical duties. In that, I have discussed the first part of the question on the previous video. So, if anyone interested to know that video, please go through my YouTube channel so you will be able to understand the discussion of that. Today, I'm going to pick the discussions on the second part. The second part is discuss whether the finance director of KEL shall would be acting ethically if we revised the accounting policy for its properties from the revaluation model to the cost model. Now, the one of the accounting standard requirement which that states that IAS 1, the IAS 1 presentation of financial statement says that you have to comply with all the applicable accounting standards when preparing and presenting financial statement. And accordingly, when there is a situation or requirement to change an accounting policy, we have to then follow IAS 8. IAS 8 is changes in accounting policies, accounting estimates, and correction of errors. Accordingly, now in this situation, when we are going through the scenario, we understand that the market conditions for the property is falling. Market condition for the property is falling, and as a result, if the business is following the revaluation model, then that will then incur losses. So the finance director is thinking that in order to mitigate this, what he's planning is to change from revaluation model to cost model. That's what he's thinking. Revaluation model to cost model. So when this wanted to happen, but the expectation of the finance director is that when he's changing to cost model, there would be significant savings, and so the bottom line in the profit and loss account will be much better. And as a result, so when the profits are bigger, so the finance director's remuneration will be as related to the bottom line, which is profit, and the bonuses according to the short-term profit, he might be benefited better. That was his thinking. This is not ethically correct because the directors are supposed to ethically comply with all the ethical principles. There are objectivity, integrity, competence, professional due care, and all that ethical principles. Accordingly, now when this finance director is supposed to be competent, professionally competent, which means that he should be aware about the required accounting treatments and accounting standard requirements when preparing the financial statement. As a result, he must be aware about the requirement of IAS 8. So, if he is intending to change in this way, he just can't do like that. He has to follow the correct requirements. Now, in order to change accounting policies, there are two situations. One, any new accounting standard requires the change, or that presentation provides a reliable and a more realistic presentation. And in this situation, which none of them are satisfying, so he can't change it. And further, on the other hand, he also need to aware that changing to cost model also may lead to the substantial financial losses because when changing to cost model, the properties needed to be depreciated. And when the properties are needed to depreciate, the depreciation will hit the profit and loss account, and that depreciation will decrease the profits, and as a result, the cost model may be even worse than the revaluation model because In revaluation model, according to IAS 8, if you have any previous revaluation gain and currently you have a revaluation deficit, you really don't need to write off to profit and loss account. Instead, you can then deduct or offset the revaluation surplus presented in other comprehensive income and statement of changes in equity. And to the extent of any previous revaluation surplus, you can still offset that. So, and any more only, you may have to write off to profit and loss account. Based on the scenario, we may guess that there may be possible previous revaluation surplus, which still could be offset. So therefore, the director's act, that is what he is planning to change the accounting policy from what he called revaluation model to cost model, is ethically not correct and it is an unethical behavior. If he is doing that, he is not professionally competent. Also, he is not presenting financial in an objective manner. So that could be a discussion for question part number B. Let's read the part C. Discuss whether CEO's comment to finance director is ethical and what action, if any, the finance director should take. Now, you can understand that here, that if I draw the organization chart, the CEO would be here and finance director here. So the finance director is an employee or subordinate for CEO. So generally the finance director will be under pressure to act according to the requirements of the CEO. Now, based on the scenario what we have gone through, the CEO is holding the share options, and if the moment when he wanted to retire from the company, he could be materialize those share options and then he can transfer that to shares and to sell them. And then he had to plan to make some cash benefits. So, in order to do that, what he is saying to the finance director is that to increase the share price of the company. How the share price can be increased, provided the company's performance are being presented better. And if the finance director preparing a set of financial statement that is artificially fabricated and producing a much enhanced, increased profits, then it could attract the potential shareholders, and as a result, the share price may increase. So, the director of finance, if he does that, he is unethical in his whatever the action he is doing. Again, we expecting that these directors are under an obligation to fulfill the ethical duties by that saying that he must be aware about the accounting requirements and standard requirement, and how should he prepare the financial statement. And he also should be professionally competent, and he must be independent, and also he should be integrity must be maintained. When director of finance is attempting to accept the requirements of the CEO, then he is violating the requirements of independence, and also he is not complying with professional competence requirements. So therefore, if he changes, and that will be an issue. When, if the director finance to act ethically, what he must be doing is, he should explain this situation to the CEO that such a change may not be possible. But if he still, the CEO is making a pressure, if you really read this here, now what the CEO really wants is this. The CEO is holds a large number of share options. Mentioned that the finance director that the retire within the next year, and was hoping to maximize the case share price. So accordingly, if the director of finance goes and explains this to the CEO and explain the position of the director of finance. However, still the CEO is pressurizing them. So what should he do is that he should reach to some people on top of the CEO, such as there could be independent directors who are known as non-executive directors, who are independent to the executive directors, and they are not office bearers. The director of finance need to explain this situation to them. Now, it's mainly if that company already has an audit committee, they should be explaining this to the audit committee. The director of finance must be explaining the situation to the audit committee. If there is no audit committee, then generally he should explain this to the non-executive directors. Suppose even if that requirement is not being accomplished by the non-executive directors, then director of finance must consider reporting this matter to the regulatory authorities within the territory, within the regime. So, but one thing need to be aware that already director of finance is in the intention of fabricating. And then CEO also have the same understanding. He also wanted to fabricate the results. So in this situation, when the CEO talks to the finance director, they may work together. They may work on collusion. And this could be very dangerous. And that is the answer for this question. I will pick some other questions as well on time to time. Next, I'm planning to take up one consolidated financial statement question on SBRs, and we'll be discussing. In order to receive this similar type of questions and interpretation technical videos, please do subscribe to my YouTube channel and like my videos, and as well press the bell button at the bottom of these videos so that it will be beneficial to you and even others. Thank you very much for watching this video, and see you soon.